What you and I would know as king or tiger prawns were once an exotic delicacy, but today around 50,000 tons pour into the UK each year, mainly from the warm waters of Latin America and Asia. This is Dhaka, capital of Bangladesh. In recent times, the country has supplied thousands of tons of prawns to the UK each year. Most end up in restaurants and smaller shops across Britain. I've come here to see what happens to some of these prawns on their way to our plates.
Well, I'm on my way now to meet a woman who's been a close observer of the fishing industry here in Bangladesh for many years now. She believes there are significant problems with the prawn farming and production business in this country, and she thinks British consumers should know about them.
Kushi, how do you do?
Kushi Kabir has been running a charity in Bangladesh for 20 years, which works with local communities in areas where the prawn industry is established. She believes the industry is dangerously unregulated.
There's over 200,000 hectares of land under shrimp aquaculture. It's impossible to trace where your shrimp is coming from. And it's also impossible to ensure that everybody who's doing the shrimp farming are following the rules that they're supposed to follow. It's not possible to do that.
Prawns are one of Bangladesh's largest exports. The industry is controlled by powerful business interests with strong connections to the authorities. We were warned our reporting might not be welcome. To avoid raising suspicion, I stayed in Dhaka and we sent an undercover team out to investigate. They decided to follow the supply chain from start to finish. In Bangladesh, prawns originate in thousands of different ponds where they're farmed. Then they're often bought by middlemen traders and sold on to processing factories. Finally, they're exported to the UK and other countries. First, our team travelled to some of the ponds around the city of Khulna at the beginning of this chain. This is Bangladesh's largest prawn production region. But hygiene is not what you would hope. The team found latrines filled with raw sewage draining into canals next to prawn ponds. As its title, water from the canals flows both into and out of the prawn ponds at every tide, carrying the sewage with it. Nearby, our team approached a man who's been farming for 20 years to ask about his methods. He told us he had big problems with disease in his prawns and poured a chemical named thiodine into the water to control it. We've disguised his identity. Thiodine is a pesticide containing a substance called endosulfan that is banned in over 50 countries around the world, including the EU. Endosulfan is widely agreed to be a toxic pollutant to the environment. Ingestion in large quantities is linked to numerous human health risks, such as paralysis and birth defects. In Bangladesh, its use is supposed to be controlled. However, the farmer didn't appear to know about any risks nor any regulation. This fitted with our discovery that Bangladeshi prawns have had problems with banned chemicals. These have frequently been found in shipments to the UK in recent years. After prawns are grown in ponds in Bangladesh, they're often bought by middlemen traders. One, who worked in the industry for 40 years, told us many of his colleagues inject prawns with a bulking liquid to increase their weight. He showed us how it's done. He feared recriminations for exposing this, so we've not identified him.
দুইটা মানে বাড়তেছে অঙ্ক অঙ্ক বাড়তেছে অর্থাৎ তাদের লাভ হচ্ছে কী করে ওজন বাড়াচ্ছে এক কেজি মাছ কিনলি এক কেজি 200 হচ্ছে প্রায় গড়ে সবাই শুরু করেছে
He estimated that 70% of prawns in the surrounding areas are treated like this. The team then travelled to a prawn auction about 20 miles outside Khulna. Middlemen sometimes buy and sell prawns at places like this before they reach processing factories which export to the UK. The team spoke to one who'd been trading at this auction for a year. He explained there is no effective system for tracing prawns back to where they're farmed. Again, we've hidden his face.
No, there is no system. I mean, the fish that we get, we keep them in different places. Total fish, about 100 million. We keep them in 100 places.
What he said shows that the factories exporting prawns to the UK, which he supplies, ultimately have little idea about which farms provide their prawns, and therefore about what conditions are like on those farms.
মানে ডিপো ফ্যাক্টরিতে মাছ নিয়ে গেলে তারা আর কি বলে না যে কোন জায়গার মাছ শুনতে চায় না কোথাকার মাছ
At this auction, there again appeared to be serious hygiene problems. Prawns being washed in well water. Swarms of flies on unrefrigerated produce. A stray dog wandering around, chewing on bits of prawns. Dispatches discovered another alarming aspect to the prawn industry in Bangladesh. Exports are big business, and many locals here have complained of being forcibly evicted from their land to make way for prawn farms. Kushi Kabir has long campaigned against the industry because of these kinds of abuses.
The human rights violations have been enormous, and the impunity of people who can get away with this has led to this being one of the most worst and the most violent industries I have ever seen.
Our undercover team went to meet a family. The father described how his entire village was evicted when a group of men turned up.
এসে উঠে আমাদের মারধর করে তাড়িয়ে দেয় বা বিভিন্নভাবে হয়রানি বা হুমকি দেয় দিয়ে তারা দখল করে নেয়
He said these men destroyed the villagers' livelihoods by flooding the land with salt water for prawn farming.
জমিতে ধান পান কেটে নিয়ে যায় এবং পুরো জমিটাই তলিয়ে দেয় এবং পরে বাধা দিতে গেলে তারা মারপিট বা বিভিন্ন হুমকি দেখায়
He said that since last March, He's been living on a small piece of land and has struggled to feed his family properly. He told us he's been threatened with death if he tries to reclaim his land. We established that prawn farms in this area are part of the supply chains of processing factories in Khulna, which export to the UK. Back in the capital, Dhaka, I watched some of the footage that our team had collected in the field. It left me with some serious questions about eating prawns from Bangladesh.
Watching this footage, you realize how little we know about where the prawns we eat have come from. And without proper traceability, it's impossible to work out what may have happened to them on their long journey from the farmer to your dinner plate. And it's difficult to see how the conditions under which these prawns are produced and traded meet European standards of food safety and hygiene.